So let's look at the solution to our multi-core versus single-core quiz. This is what we had in the old technology. In the new technology, one of these cores is going to be half the size and half the power. So we have the option of either replacing that with a better core that occupies the whole area, gets us more IPC, but consumes slightly more power. And then the question is, if we do consume the whole power budget of the chip, which is 100 watts, how much can we increase this frequency? And with that frequency, what is the overall speed up versus what we had in the old technology? The other option was just put the two cores that we can now fit on the chip. Each now gets us the same IPC as the single core did. And together, they consume the whole power budget of the chip at 2 GHz. So the question is, what's the speed up versus the old technology with the two core approach? The first thing we need to figure out here is how much can we raise this frequency here so that we get to 100 watts. Well, we are allowed to increase the power from 75 watts to 100 watts. That's a factor of 1.33. Remember that the dynamic power is proportional to voltage squared times the frequency itself, and that we have to increase the voltage in proportion to frequency. So if we are spending power to increase the frequency, we have to proportionally get both the voltage and the frequency up. And that means that we will be spending power in proportion to the cube of the frequency. That means that the frequency that we can operate on is cubic root of 133 times the old frequency, and this is equal to 1.1. So our new frequency is 1.1 times the old frequency. The old frequency was 2 GHz. That means we can achieve 2.2 GHz when we increase the power by a factor of 1.33. The speed up we achieve versus the old technology will be the speed up we achieve because of a shorter clock cycle time, and that speed up is 1.1 times. So we are 1.1 times faster now in terms of clock frequency, times the speed up we achieve because our IPC is better. And if we divide 3.5 and 2.5, we get a factor of 1.4 times the speed up we achieve because we have fewer instructions. But because we are executing exactly the same code, that speed up is 1. We don't speed up really. So our overall speed up is just this, and it ends up being 1.54. Now let us look at the two core option. We have the same IPC as before, but we now have two cores that are doing that. So we are executing twice as many instructions as before at the same frequency and at the same power. So the speed up versus the old system here will simply be 2. We are operating at the same frequency, splitting the same work into two pieces, and each of the pieces is now done at the speed where we were doing only one of the pieces. So overall, we are getting a speed up of 2. As you can see, two cores are achieving a better speed up relative to the old system than a fancier core, which means that if we indeed do have programs that can use the two cores effectively, then this is the better option than improving the core and consuming the chip area that way.